Following safe passage through the firmly blue House, the American Rescue Plan is off to the Senate, where the Biden administration will need every Democrat senator to vote with the bill to ensure it gets passed by the simple majority required by the budget reconciliation method. This will be easier now that the $15 minimum wage provision has been removed, a provision two Democratic senators opposed after being deemed extraneous to budget legislation by Senate parliamentarian Elizabeth McDonough. The progress of the bill is going to be of great interest to investors, both those hoping for it to pass and those fearful of the inflationary pressures that may be created by its success. Though they stabilised over the weekend, markets will also be on high alert for another rise in bond yields after February came to a deleterious end due to falling bond prices. All this hinges on the potential for a surge in inflation as the global economy recovers, a recovery that will, in part, be driven by Biden's $1.9 trillion package and the measures central banks may take to combat that scenario. The big, as yet unanswerable question is whether this fear of rising inflation is justified. The third major item on the US agenda this week is Friday's non-farm jobs report. For four of the last 5 months, the reading has drastically underperformed expectations, including the negative number seen for December. The reading did rebound in January, however, if not at the pace analysts were expecting, while there were positive signs elsewhere, with the unemployment rate dropping to its lowest level since last April. This time out, analysts are forecasting another improving figure, up from 49,000 in January to 133,000 in February. The unemployment rate, meanwhile, is expected to nudge higher to 6.4%. However, it has seen 10 consecutive months of better than forecast readings. Average hourly earnings finally are estimated to stay unchanged at 0.2%. Before that, there's the final market and ISM manufacturing PMIs on Monday and the services equivalent on Wednesday, alongside the ADP non-farm reading, while Thursday has factory orders and the usual jobless claims number. As for earnings, one of the most intriguing releases is Zoom's fourth quarter figures on Monday. One of the major pandemic success stories, the pressure is going to be on the video chat app to pitch its value once things start to go back to normal, hopefully in the coming months. In terms of the figures themselves, estimates would indicate a 420% surge in earnings to 78 cents off a 330% jump in sales to $809 million. As mentioned, however, the big three items this week for the US markets are going to be the progress of the stimulus plan through the Senate, the state of the bonds market throughout the rest of the week. You know, obviously, they have settled over the weekend, allowing the markets to rebound on Monday, but there's nothing to say there won't be another sort of spiking activity as the week goes on. And then finally, on Friday, the non-farm jobs report, which I guess may play into those former two factors. If the non-farm jobs does rebound aggressively, it may call into question the need for such a big stimulus package, and then may cause fears of those inflationary pressures to re-emerge once again at the end of the week. As Raz said, the non-farm figures have broadly been struggling in the last 4 to 5 months. So even that suggested improvement on Friday is no way near guaranteed.